In this class, let us learn Coulomb's law. Coulomb's law gives an expression for the electrostatic force between two point charges, Q1 and Q2, separated by a distance r. The force is directly proportional to product of the charges Q1, Q2. Magnitude of product of the charges and inversely proportional to square of the distance, r square. It is a central force as it acts along the line joining the two charges. So F is equal to a constant into modulus Q1, Q2 by r square. The constant K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 is equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9 Newton meter square per Coulomb square. And epsilon 0 is equal to 8.854 into 10 raised to minus 12 Coulomb square per Newton per meter square. It is known as permittivity of free space. So let us define one Coulomb. If Q1 is equal to Q2 is equal to 1 Coulomb and R is equal to 1 meter, then force F is equal to K is equal to 9 into 10 raised to 9 Newton. So 1 Coulomb is the charge when placed at a distance 1 meter from a similar charge experiences a force 9 into 10 raised to 9 Newton in vacuum or free space. Since force is a vector quantity, let us write force in vector form. We are considering two charges Q1 and Q2. Both are either positive or negative, like charges. Like charges repel. So the force acting on Q1 by Q2, F12, acts along the line joining the charges and directed away from Q2 as the force is repulsive. Similarly, force acting on Q2 by Q1, F21, is directed away from Q1. R12, it denotes the direction from Q1 to Q2. It is a unit vector which gives the direction from Q1 to Q2. If both charges are like charges, then the product Q1, Q2 is positive or greater than 0. And the distance between 1 and 2, R12, is equal to R. So vector F12 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 modulus Q1, Q2 by R square into minus R12. The force F12 is directed opposite to the vector R12. The force F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 modulus Q1, Q2 by R square into R12. F21 is directed in the same direction as that of R12. Both the forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. Let us consider unlike charges. Unlike charges attract. Q1 and Q2 are unlike charges. So force on 1 by 2, F12, is directed towards Q2 and F21 is directed towards Q1. The product Q1, Q2 is negative, that is less than 0 for unlike charges. So vector F12 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 modulus Q1 Q2 by R square into R cap 12. F12 is in the same direction of R cap 12. And F21 is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 modulus Q1 Q2 by R square into minus R cap 12, as F21 is opposite in direction as that of R cap 12. Both the forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. So Coulomb's law agrees with the Newton's third law. Vector F12 is equal to minus vector F21. Both the forces are equal in magnitude but opposite in direction. In a medium other than air, the constant K is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon. And epsilon by epsilon 0 is the relative permittivity or K, dielectric constant. Therefore, we can write epsilon is equal to K times epsilon 0. Epsilon is the permittivity of the medium. The dielectric constant is the relative permittivity. It is the ratio of permittivity of a medium to the permittivity of free space. So let us take the ratio of the electrostatic force between two charges in air to that in a medium. It is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon 0 by 1 by 4 pi epsilon. It is equal to epsilon by epsilon 0, and that is equal to K. So we can define K, or dielectric constant, as the ratio of the electrostatic force between two charges in air to the force between the same charges in the medium. Thank you.